Hey everyone, welcome to our second viewer Q&A, where we answer questions from viewers like you. Our first question comes from Deborah Baker. What is the one item inside your tab that you could not live without?
Oh dear. My initial reaction was to say our Roku stick, which allows us to watch Hulu and Netflix on our TV in our camper. But the more I think about it, the more I realize that it's our cast iron skillets that I can't live without. Whether cooking on the stove or in a campfire, I cook almost exclusively on the cast iron.
I absolutely can't function in the morning without coffee, and finding the right coffee solution on the road was kind of a chore. But finally, the French press ended up winning, and that is my most important item. More specifically, our 48-ounce insulated French press by Planetary Design. Other must-have accessories for coffee on the road are an airtight container to keep your coffee in, a manual hand-crank grinder, and of course, a Kendrick to make you coffee every morning.
Our second question comes from Daria Riley Seeley. I'm wondering if there is a way to determine how large you can go when printing an image before the quality deteriorates.
First, let me briefly describe resolution in terms of pixel dimension and DPI. That's dots per inch. To make it easy, let's assume we have an image that's 2400 by 3600 pixels. So if we set that at 300 DPI, we would take the number of pixels on each side, divide that by 300, and that would give us the number of inches we'd be printing at that resolution, which in this case would only be an 8-inch by 12-inch print. Now, if we were to divide that same image by 72 instead of 300, we'd end up with 33 inches by 50 inches. So that brings us to the main question, is what DPI should you be printing at?
Like anything else, there's an ideal setting, and then there's the question of how far can you push things and still be acceptable. Before printing, you should answer these three questions. How big do you want to print? On what medium will you be printing? And where will you be hanging this print?
In an ideal world, the recommended print resolution is 300 DPI, but this isn't an ideal world. I've printed as low as 200 DPI or even 150 DPI and still been okay with the outcome.
The material you want to print on also matters. For instance, you can get away with a lot lower DPI on textured paper like matte, or especially on material like canvas. Some processes like dye sublimation on the metal are also more forgiving. But if you're going to print to high gloss or metallic paper, you're going to want a better resolution.
Now, I'm all about practical application. Let's consider where you're going to be hanging this piece of art. If it's going to go in a hallway or somewhere where the viewer is up close, obviously it's more important that you have a good high resolution. But if the piece of art's going to be hanging up high in a large room where the viewer will never be closer than 20 or 30 feet, you're going to have a lot more flexibility. And finally, if you really need your image to be a higher resolution, there's a few applications to help you do this. The process of adding pixels to your image is called interpolation. In addition to Photoshop, there are third-party applications dedicated to enlarging images. A couple of my favorite are Blow Up by Alien Skin and also Resize by On One. And our final question comes from Mr. Danny Head, who asks, in such close quarters, how do you both handle it after having refried beans?
I'm glad you asked that, Danny. I lived in the back of my truck with my stinky running and climbing shoes for about 4.5 years, so I'm pretty sure I lost my sensitivity to bad smells like that.
You know, I just keep a cork on hand in case Kendrick gets gassy. So if you have a question, be sure to subscribe to our channel and comment below. You can also find us on Facebook and Instagram at Mandy Lee Photo. So here's to more questions from viewers like you. Love and light.
Got a beard here on me.
Get it off.
It's not mine.
Is it on my beard?
You want me to plug
my beard?
It on?
Beard. Okay.